Massachusetts is setting very high expectations for its students in hope that they will be successful once they leave the classroom and education system. They're trying to incorporate habits of mind and ways of thinking and application on top of just learning content.
I believe that the standards provide a solid foundation for our students from which they can build throughout their academic experiences in terms of the content that should be taught as well as the skills that should be mastered at different grade levels.
We want students to engage in meaningful real-world problems every day. Our hope is that they would take the knowledge and skills learned in the classroom and use that in everyday life and society.
Standards are important because they make sure that everyone is aligned, right? They give every classroom purpose. They ground you in what you're trying to accomplish every day. And they also maintain equity for kids across classroom and make sure that everyone's getting a fair opportunity at a quality education.
So really they're measuring what kids can do and how kids think instead of can they memorize their multiplication tables.
We've got math content that we need to learn, but we're trying to come across the other direction with how students should engage with it and building their skills and their habits, not just their knowledge of how to solve for X or how to take a derivative, but their knowledge of how to engage with problems and do kind of structured problem solving.
If I'm just saying, when I divide fractions, I just multiply by the reciprocal, or I just keep change flip, that's not gonna help my student to be able to apply those skills later. But I teach them to look for the patterns and how patterns make up mathematics and logical thinking and looking at those patterns, that's going to help them engage in that mathematics.
Problem solving teaches students to think, and it teaches them to think independently. The idea of formulating what do I need to do in order to reach an end goal, how do I work with the people around me to get to that end goal, it goes through all areas of life.
So students have this idea that math cannot be used outside the classroom. The revision to the standards, to me, has changed that. We involve the real world concepts like ratio and proportion, so simple interest, purchasing things in a store.
When deciding what real world problems I choose in my class, I have to be very cautious of the culture I have in my classroom and the interests of my students. So if I come up with this great problem, but the students have no idea the background of the problem, that real world problem will actually get in the way of them understanding the mathematics.
It's necessary to consider all the different populations that you have in a classroom in order to bring in different real world situations where all children find them approachable.
Because you can create a real world problem, but if it's not relevant to the student, it truly is not a real world problem to them.
To see students later in life and to see what they've accomplished, and they call back and say, I'm in college, or you see them on the street and they tell you, I'm attending this college or this university, I think that's what makes it all worth it.